Good evening, everybody, and welcome back to the ECS NA division. I'm joined by two lovely Europeans, one of which knows something about Counter-Strike, and the other is Henry G. How are we doing this evening?
Yeah, I'm okay. I mean, how can this keep on going after what you experienced in Bucharest?
What did I experience?
Well, I got
three,
what do you say after
sick,
that one, man?
Sick op shots in a row on him.
I'm very glad for you, Matt.
Thank you.
I'm very glad for
I
you.
I am too.
You did get wrecked, of course.
Don't care.
Hashtag bot sadokist.
Hashtag ripcadian. That's the only hashtag that we need to take away from that event. So, we do go into tonight a little bit better off than the last two North American nights, because the last two we had without a roof, who's obviously just made roster changes and aren't stable at all yet after losing Slemmy as their in-game leader. And we also saw a number of teams that were really struggling last night. Obviously, Cloud9 winning their matchup quite convincingly against, who are they playing? Henry?
Cloud9.
Without a roof.
Yes.
Sorry, LG played them as well. Yep. That's what I was going at. Mm. Either way, tonight we actually have some stable rosters. TSM comes into this with Sempus a little bit more. I guess he's kind of leading the charge on that team. But obviously they go up against NRG, which has the structure of Gabi coming over in Legia, your countryman, who's been doing very well over there. They've had a good run in North America. And then we have Cloud9 versus Luminosity, which is an awesome matchup. We'll start with the first one, though. I'm just going to look at you. That's my throw.
I mean, both of these teams at the beginning of the year, there were a lot of question marks surrounding both of them, especially TSM, considering the previous lineup they had. It was the Danish lineup of Astralis. It was playing under that name. And also about NRG, why Gobbi moving to North America makes sense. A good in-game leader, it's what the North American scene was lacking, but maybe via Legia with him and so on. But they proved that they've constantly been improving. You know, they've been on an upward swing, had a good result at Counterpit, beating Envious in a best of three as well. TSM, on the other hand, not that many good results, some online wins here and there, but in the end, I remember Sempus tweeting a couple of days ago that, you know, he thinks that they've been improving steadily and that's all that matters. So, you know, time will tell if he's right.
Have we seen TSM at any sort of event?
Not really, no.
Nothing at all?
No. And, okay. I mean, obviously they're priming for E-League as well. That's their main focus.
I think that's
I don't know if it's their main focus, but at this point in time with the roster as it is and the timing of the roster, that seems to be the one that makes the most sense. Because Echo Fox was the team I was talking about last night. That obviously made a roster change to bring on Ichiban and A2Z being replaced as well. On this one, we do have the map veto that was on screen. It's going to be Train, Mirage, and Dust 2. Starting out on Train, TSM versus NRG, Gobbi being strategical.
Well, this is the first night we've actually seen full lineups, so we haven't got any changes going into this
exactly.
one. So it should be interesting. Obviously, we talk about NRG do a lot of homework here. They have the gaming house in Vegas, so they actually do a lot of work together. I'm sure they've done a lot of prep.
I would not be gaming if I had a gaming house in Vegas.
Probably the worst place for you to be on the planet, I'd imagine.
Renegades are there as well.
So. Yeah.
I don't even like that city, but it would be fun.
So I can't say I've watched many TSM games. I haven't seen many events. That's what we really do at the moment. So. NRG, from what I've seen, they seem like a very tactical team. The last time we saw them at LAN, obviously missing Peter. But I'm sure they're going to be coming in very strong in this one. They're the heavy favourites, I would say, in terms of what I've seen so far. TSM, I can't imagine they're going to do too much in this, but like I said, I haven't watched too much of them.
It's hard to call someone a heavy favourite in an online game, especially... I mean, even in EU, we had a lot of upsets that, you know, FaZe beating Fnatic 2-0... In a best of, I think it was in Pro League, so it was a two best of ones. But sure. It's really hard with these online games. You know, it most of the times, even though it sounds a bit silly, it depends on the form of the day, which team shows up. Because you know, you would think that teams with more structure, right, they would be able to overcome those difficulties as well. But again, in the EU region versus Pro, losing again to FaZe in the ECS after winning the first map, then losing 2-1. So anything can happen. Basically, if one of the players on TSM has a great game, then maybe that could edge the series towards their way. But I agree that on paper, NRG should take this.
And the last time I watched him play Train was against Complexity.
Yes.
And they absolutely battered him. I think it was the opening game for Complexity in this league, and they looked like they got absolutely wrecked. But that's a team that's been very turbulent recently, lots of up and down results. So it's very difficult to take anything away from that. I'm looking forward to see what they bring to the table. For me, this is more like just a gauge to see where these teams are at right now, kind of see what they bring to the table, see how tactical they are, whether they're running more defaults. I've heard that's what TSM are more into, kind of running picks and making defaults instead of heavy executed strats. Where NRG, on the other hand, they've got a plethora of tactics they can bring to the table and obviously rely very heavily on the Peter Orp. I'm sure we'll be seeing some of that coming out. He can be a very strong player if he is on good form. So Especially against someone like TSM, I'd expect them to play very well.
All right, we're going to jump into the pistol round right away, but final thoughts, I guess going into this, we all kind of conclude NRG should be the favorite quite convincingly.
I agree, especially on train. It is their pick. Now, a lot of teams play it generally, not just in the NA region. So it is something that they should have a clear advantage on, and I would be really surprised if TSM takes this one.
All right, well, we'll find out. Thank you, Yanko. We'll let you go press some buttons to make sure we're watching the right players so that I can try and do my job in some sort of fashion that is effective. It's not going to be likely. But Justin already out toward Ivy at this point in time. He's pretty much the only one on that outer position at the A site. Three players looking for a quick rotation toward that Zed connector.
Yeah, TSM holding up at the moment. You can see the Desert Eagle is out on Semphis, so he's gone to the last hand into the Nico. We see a lot of teams trying to do this at the moment, but you have to be a pretty special talent to be able to pull it off. Let's see what he can do with this one. They have got smoke and a Molotov remaining. No one really committed to anything just yet. It's holding for any CT aggression. That's Semphis towards inside, trying to get that first shot, but Godby spots him. Falls back to more of a passive position now. And the terrorists still have plenty of time here. They're not going to be forcing anything just yet. That one smoke, you'd assume that's going to be for planting outside, so maybe just in between the bomb train and the green and see if they can get a plant out with those couple of flashbangs they have, but adjusting themselves now, potentially going back towards inside.
Look at this, look at the mini-map. Have you ever seen five players lined up like that? Like just straight line down the map. Passive hold on A as set, should silent playing at the latter position of control room would be able to rotate over quite quickly as well. But no commitment so far from TSM. Late into the round, 40 seconds to go on a pistol. Smoke going to go back out toward Ivy. Molotov that's failed. It clipped the edge of the bomb train, so he's got full motion, Peter, still to try and take advantage of this situation, and he will. Good damage dealt so far in a twist. But you haven't followed it up just yet.
Bombs have actually gone inside here, so this is more of a fake going on. So the bomb will be planted. It's actually pretty convincing, although they failed those Molotovs. Silent picks up the first kill. He'll be taken down as well. FNS trying to face there. Trying to get aggressive. This is the correct methodology when trying to push the inside side, but Peter finds a kill on towards him. 5-on-3 now. They have actually not got a single kill here, so they need to act quickly. And we're going to do what we can here on the bomb train. Sick, taking on Silent, but it's going to be the round over. NRG will be taking this one, surely, as we have one final player here coming in.
Going to be automatic. That goes down immediately to Godby. So good job for NRG actually to retake that quite convincingly considering the fake, because it was effective. They had everyone rotated to the outer site. They had three players on the B platforms, but unfortunately they couldn't do anything with it.
Well, they got the bomb down, so it means they will be getting AKs in the third. So NRG, interesting buy for them considering that is going to be the prospect going forward. Obviously, UMP is still very viable in today's meta, but there's an MP9 chucked in there as well. We know the AKs will be coming out. Most teams will be getting Famuses in this sort of procedure, but we'll see how this one goes down for them. This should be almost a throwaway round. TSM's real objective is just to try and get the bomb planted. They'll be heading towards inside. They've got no utility to work with here, so they're hoping they can maybe catch an aggressive CT player. Peter with the scout towards connector, looking towards main. But so far, waiting for the smoke to extinguish first and see whether they can find some sort of entrance here to one of the sites.
Falling away, Justin. Let's go SMGs. FNS is going to climb this ladder up. Get back over towards 6, see if they can start to work toward the inner bomb site. It is just Godby that's playing in there right now at the bottom of the ramp. Molotov cocked and ready. Going to need to get rid of it soon. I'm not sure he spotted FNS just yet. He's a little bit shallow on that last shoulder peak, and now he's going to fall back slightly with that UMP. No need to commit to this. No need to waste the utility just yet. He doesn't need to be bled dry with 40 seconds left, because if he still has it at around the 30-second mark, it'll pay dividends. They are still approaching on that inner site with the bomb. One player way out toward Ivy is going to try and distract them right now. That's automatic. Peter and Silent are close enough that it wouldn't take much to keep them there if they could get some noise in. Twist also back up the ladder. This is going to be on the Gabi, and now he'll throw it. 22 seconds better still. Teammate just takes it away, though. Thanks very much. I saved that for a reason. I wanted to have a hot dog fest, but unfortunately, the smoke takes that away. Unfortunately, what it doesn't do is take away his UMP. And TSM go down. Sick and twist fall. It is automatic late lurk coming out from Ivy to find one kill. Bomb gets planted again. This is decent all of a sudden. Semphis picks up a kill. Ligia's got to come back around. He's got the M4. 10 seconds to hold this, and he might get a little bit complacent. He knows the rotation's coming in, but this is too...
Oh, God, it's actually going to work out.
Sempit's going to just rush that almost. It might have been interesting.
Pretty smart from the gear. Like, that's a big play. That was so 50-50. You saw Sempit considering running down at that point. He was counting in his head as well. He knew he was late to it, and he probably heard the defuse, but the gear decides to hold on. That must have taken balls of steel, but worked out for him. Very decent round from TSM, as you said. Now this is a real problem for NRG. They did go into those SMGs, so they did struggle holding it off. The bomb gets planted once again for TSM, so they have a very strong buy going into this one. Five AKs, all the utility required for an Axel execution here as well. CTs are struggling. They have got M4s, but you see, not everything they need to hold them off. It should be one of the bigger rounds. TSM could win this one. Could mean it's a double eco here for NRG. We'll see what goes on. Got to be looking for that first pick. He's the smoke to his advantage as well, but takes heavy nade damage.
Shots come in though. Sempit reigns supreme against Gobby. No Jaden here because of all the deaths in the last round. Ligia's gonna get back up close toward the inner bomb site again this time. Playing it from the Taz side of the train.
Yeah, well, TSM with the man advantage here. Still got four smokes available.
Yeah.
So he can go for a full execution here. Just wait for the reaction to come from the CTs. Ligia's gonna be hunting for information. If he faces this corner, he's probably going to take him down. You can see automatic waiting for him there. His next kill is going to be huge. But it's going to be Sarnen taking most of the damage. He takes down Sempit. This will force automatic to come around and face. The gear needs to step up here.
That's an Ivy as well, which leaves a third player way back. Automatic takes the first shot, but loses the duel. And Silent's low. That Molotov was horribly thrown. That does not spread in that pattern. So Silent can just sit in there still and be a pest. But it is sick to take the gear late. Peter's rotated over early. No AWP for him. It's just the M4 to work with so far. Smoke out. Late onto sidewalk, but it's a fake. They actually want to try and take this bomb back down ladder. The problem is, though, that they've got a player still inside the inner bomb site. Rotating now, but he's caught in the open. FNX nearly finds Justin. Late Molotov toward the hitch. Justin's going to have to be limited in his movements. Just try and hold on from control room instead. Silently climbing the ladder, and Peter has to wait for Sick. Goes down. Now they've got the real flank potential. TSM against Silent. 8 HP. And that's all too easy when he missed that shot. Good play from FNX.
NRG.
FNX, excuse me.
Yes, true. NRG did what they could there. They lost our first pick. And we saw the reaction coming in towards it inside site. And Ligia did find the kill, but there's too many fakes going on. TSM sticking together, having that inside potential as well. One player coming in with the flanks is holding one of the CTs off. The frags come in towards the outside area. As I said before, NRG now pretty much on a double eco. They get $1,400 going for this round. And they're sat at about $1,800, so they definitely can't buy next round either. So some players investing in some partial upgrades here. Desert Eagles, 5.7s, body armor. Justin actually gone for head armor, which... let's kind of work out here, considering the R3 SMGs available for TSM. But this should be a case of slowing it down, working in default, getting the picks. And it's almost certainly going to be 2-2 here, but you never know with the Desert Eagles. And online CS, as Janko mentioned in the analysis section.
Things you never knew, you never knew. Sempit waiting for the push out toward Ivy, no one going this time. But how quickly the pistols are brought back out from NRG. And Gobby spots up one on top of the train, but they're already planting it. Good headshot on a twist. Might have a chance to deny this. They actually have to get off the bomb plant. Gives more time to the rotation, but Sick will stick now. But McGee's got FNS. This is actually turning out to be all right. Automatic finally with a kill from the terrorist side. And as Sick gets forward with that MAC-10, he'll find Ligia. And Automatic holds on still with the AK. Fast sensitivity, a high sensitivity for Automatic. He's known for it. He's no
point.
Professor Chaos, but...
he uses high sensitivity.
I think he played with like something like 5 or something ridiculous.
Fair enough. NRG there, they do pick up 3 kills, and TSM, actually 2 very low HP players to hold it off there. But they played that round well, 3 SMGs, got the decent smokes down the lower ramp. And the good thing about going inside is what you need to be doing is once a bomb gets planted, you'll be pushing down and stop the rotations coming from the CT, make it difficult for them to get out. And this is a very strange buy. So NRG, instead of taking the eco here, they've actually gone for a full force into this with 1M4, Scout, 5.7s. They wanted to do something like this. Why did they do a semi-force into the last round? It didn't really make sense, but... okay, let's go with it. We'll see what happens. 5.7s and a Scout. It's going to be Godby going aggressive on the lower ramp here. Twist should be able to find him here. It's a pretty strange angle for Godby to be holding, so... definitely won't be pre-firing it, but 3 players coming around regardless. Even if he gets 1 kill, he'll be taken down just like that. Gobby doesn't find anything for that. Does do some decent damage, but that's about it. And the inside site should be pretty open here. And they're doing some interesting decisions in terms of their economy management. Now, all 5 players looking like TSM will be heading inside. Justin pushed towards main entrance. The thing is now, the terrorists don't have any map control. They kind of are committed to this. They don't have the information on the other parts of the map. So you need to go forward with this one. Legear once again on that upper ramp area, looking to see if he can pick up the first frag as they come around the corner.
It's going to fall away. But Silence here flashes through M4. It's the only one. Shoots a little early, still finds the kill. Good bait and switches. Legear comes back out from the spools. Good pop flash as well. Jumped up and perfectly played. He gets up the ladder so quickly. Has a gun to work with. Sempis and automatic. Now against four. But that rifle, that's an overcommitment. Legear finally wins a duel, gets a rifle, and then drops it back out in a position where it's not recoverable.
They had the bomb as well. They should still win the round, but still, he didn't have to die there. They could have just completely strong-armed the bomb. And now we've got automatic going down the lower ramp. Decent flashbang coming in, but time ticking away. They need to act right now. It's going to be Silent on top of the train here, looking for that next kill, and actually lands it as well. So now just Sempis with the AWP, finds a kill onto Justin, but with 8 seconds remaining. This round is over, and somehow NRG, with that interesting buy, step out massively, but still not obvious. Well, in terms of the time it is. He gets another kill, makes it a little bit more expensive for the CTs and saves the AWP as well. It's pretty massive for him. But nicely recovered, I guess, from NRG with that buy. 3 pistols, a scout, and an M4. It's that inside hold. But that TSM didn't really execute properly for that, running through smoke and got caught in the crossfire. But Legear was a very creative player with that pop flash towards the upper ramp, got him a second kill. And you can see the buy for the CT is still very lackluster. MP9, UMP, Scout, make it two of them, and an AK. He still favored TSM going into this round, considering they have an AWP as well.
Sempis is going to hold. Tight angle, a little bit of confusion, obviously, as they jump the rifle down in front of him. They high-five, hold hands, say good luck, bro, and move on with it. The Asimov is one of the coolest guns when it gets well-worn like this.
I think it looks horrible.
I think it looks great. You have no taste, though, so it's not surprising.
You want the cheapest,
I think the black
skin?
Scope looks baller, man. That's not even the full black scope, and I think it looks cool. It's like a crashed X-Wing that's a little beat up from battle, you know? Mm. I think it looks good. I think the Asimov like that. Especially with the worn up TSM logo, because they're used and abused now in CS.
Great.
4 players accumulating toward the top of the tunnels right now toward the B site. Sick will be the first in. Smoke on sidewalk, God playing close, mistimed almost having the Molotov out, but does get back in a better position. Good counter flash means he can't peek to catch the bomb cross into a plant position. And Sempis has the lineup, takes down Peter. And now the quasi-buy right now from Energy has to come up large. Gobby still has this angle to hold, but only sprays down the first one so far. Legear takes automatic with the MP9, building money. But it's still a problem because they have to get closer to this bomb still, and Gobby's the only one that has a kit. Thankfully, he's playing up close, so it'll be picked up if he goes down, but it's Legear, burn one alive. Sick goes down, and it's all on the FNS, caught in the open. Legear's got the kill.
Another massive round there from Legear. Bomb ticking away, but...
He thought about going for the kit.
Yeah, well, he could go. I think there's an AWP drops as well, so I think he was just trying to get intel as to where that was. So we'll get the defuse in. As you said, can go salvage some of the dropped goodies on the floor. Defuse kits, AWPs, and I think the AWP should be there. Absolutely.
Nah,
main target.
Not making it.
Not going to get the kit there, but now the money should be starting to stabilize for NRG. You can see TSM, even with the bomb down, they're going to struggle going into this one. They know the money's pretty low for the CT still after another one-on-one situation. FNS did what he could there towards the end. But you can see now, they're still not fully recovered. UMP on silent, mag 7 on the gear. That's still very viable inside. That can do some tremendous work. And it is a full force buy coming in from TSM this time. Why not? Like I said, they know the money is not exactly great with the CTs. They've got smokes, tech 9s, and a Galil on twist. Aggression coming in from silent. He'll be pushing for his own smoke. I'm not sure how he's going to work out for him. He managed to get himself out of the dumpster area. He's into round number 7. TSM don't want to be able to give away. They've invested into this round just yet. He'll be holding up and seeing if there is any aggression. And Silent, now he is fully committed in that area. It's going to be difficult for him to fall back and trying to get out. Does have a decent flashbang, so makes it out of that area. I think that's probably a good move. If they need to die there about a kill, it could be very problematic for his team. But it's FNS to pick up the first kill. That's towards Pop Dog. And now it's a 5-4 in favor of TSM.
Fallen firing shots at NA players today on Twitter. Did you see that?
No.
Don't worry about it. You can look it up later. I don't want to ruin your bathroom tabloids. Sempis already clears out. Hell. Sick, get silent. These Tech Nines are reigning supreme, but unfortunately, Sempis cannot land the shot with the Deagle. And Gobby's going to just be able to shut them down quite quickly. Twist does get one. He's got the Galil to work with, but comes to a 2v2 as Justin's immediately going to turn back onto him. Bomb still out toward this quad position, and Gobby needs to get a better read on this because they're starting to rotate off of A, and the bomb's going to get planted. He has the chance to peek and line them up right now, but he gives it up for free. And Six picked up the Galil as well.
He wants to make sure he's not like taking risks, unnecessary risk, I guess. Have his teammate coming in, and that should be a free kill for Gobby there. There it is, taking down Six. And now we just have Automatic with that CZ trying to find a weapon. It's just going to be a UMP. Mikala smoked out. They do have a kid as well, the CT. So flashbang coming through. It's the Hail Mary play. What can you do with this? It works out and actually gets a position behind the bomb train as well. Gobby now forced to make the next move. And it's going to be Automatic hiding behind it. He comes out on top of that situation. Very good stuff from him. Like I said, just flashing through the smoke. Hope for the best. Just has a UMP. And it's a massive route for TSM to win as well. You can see that's really affected the NRG financial situation. They're going to be forcing back as well. So very back and forth game here. 4-3 right now. That's Peter with the scouts. 4-5-7s.
I just lost game sounds. I don't know. Hopefully the stream didn't.
I'm sure it's all fine.
Ah, they're back. Everything's fine now, Henry. Don't worry about it.
I don't have sound myself. So what do you mean?
Ah, I know why it is. Don't worry. Reese has told me everything's fine. Calm down. Twist. Gets silent. FNS is going to take Gobby, and suddenly it works out. TSM getting closer to the front of the site. Bomb in their hands as well. All three together. They could back toward ladder right now, but watch this lurk from Justin because they may not be expecting this. Oh, he's spotted, though. Definitely spotted when they jump back across.
Man advantage, but Peter, and he has 10 HP with the scout. Times it pretty poorly as well. Going to be caught.
Okay, better.
That actually kind of works. Gets the bomb down as well. This could be massive. Peter finding 2 kills inside. Just going to be Semper's remaining. The problem is, Peter with 10 HP does know that Semper's coming in. He's got the information to go through, surely.
Just got around that corner. I was going to say he's going to get caught in the open because he misread slightly where Semper's timing was. Ooh. Flash goes out early. Back down the ladder. Semper's getting closer. Faces it. And it's going to be Semper's round to win.
A lot of these force buys coming right down to the wire here. And it's another one for NRG.
Problem is now they're going to be sold by it. They're going to start to believe in it.
The thing is, it makes sense against the CT tribe because it's much difficult. It's very difficult for them to rebuy into these rounds. But terrorists can have AKs all over the place, and you can see right now that it's not the best buy from them, but it's certainly not the worst. They've got 4 AKs and 1 MP7 going up against another force buy of pistols and a scout. This is very, very questionable decision coming in from NRG. Let's take a full eco. Is it going to be fun? Our first kill. They're swarming the outside bomb site. He's got himself in a decent position towards Ivy. He's going to find a second kill as well. Silent drop. And this is going to lead. That'll be a very difficult situation. 2 force buys in a row that haven't worked out. They found 1 kill. That's going to be thanks to Peter. Now there's Gobby in pretty much no man's land. Not many options here. Making his way towards T-spawn. Bomb has been
planted. Yeah, this time the force buy not going to amount for much, is it, Henry G?
Not at all. I think after you do a force spell like that, you get about like 2.3k. Just take a full eco and at least have something to work with next round. Now it's going to be TSM taking the advantage here. 5-4.
I'm going to start calling you Henry 3.
Why?
Because I got 3 op kills on you in a row.
Okay, I'll start calling you Matt 8.
Got 8 rounds, baby. I'm proud of that. I like that.
Don't be proud of that.
I rated
that's all you
eight
out of
eight. We didn't R8 1v1, bro. That's all that would have mattered. Gobby's found. No gun grabbed.
This is where we're getting a little bit of a problem for NRG. Full eco surely coming in this time. Can't have another force buy. Please, I beg. But HG grenades, PT-50s, 5.7s, and that's about it. A lot of teams will take up heavy AG usage on these kind of rounds to try and nade towards main. You can find a couple of frags to do a lot of damage. Not going to be doing that this time. Looking like an inside rush coming in from TSM here. Taking heavy control of the upper halls and maybe going back towards Pop Dog here. Semper's watching the flanks, waiting for no one to get close to main. And they'll just be executing very basically monotops towards heaven, smoking off towards connector, finding the kills, trading effectively, and Semper's to get the first kill on Peter.
Okay, yeah. Close angle. Oh, you would have thought. With the crosshair placement and him running toward him like that, he might have found the headshot. Either way, it's all TSM. Last 2 rounds quite convincingly. Twist, good shot onto Silent. And FNS takes down Justin. FNS! It's Finesse and Phoenix, all right? Let's just go with that.
FNS. I think he's a pretty well-known player. You should be able to...
It's Finesse, is actually.
Yes.
Correct.
But I think FNS is acceptable.
I think FNX is Phoenix.
Yeah.
Let's just start calling them by the full name.
Well then, we have stabilized the money slightly for NRG. AWP on Peter. It's been a while. We'll see what he can do here. Round number 11, he'll be forcing himself toward the inside area, but it's going to be Molotov. That decent read there from TSM. He has to go back to a more passive setup here. And the bomb is towards T-Sport right now, so TSM not heavily committing at the start of the round. Just holding more of a default play here. You can see two players watching Ivy, that same smoke coming down for Silent. We saw him go towards Dumpster last time, so that just buys the CD some time here. TSM going to have to clear that out now and see whether he did make his way through to that area. Maybe spend a little bit of their utility to find out. But now they're edging in. And there we go. Silent is holding the off angle here, took into that first pick. It's quite a nice little face from TSM. That means if one player dies, at least one of them will get the refrag. That's the idea behind that, at least, getting on each other's head.
Mm-hmm. Makes perfect sense, doesn't it? Silent's going to face this as well. Two players there. Not in the same position that we did see that little quick boost, but one on top of green, one facing. Nade in. It's going to go slightly deep on Twist. In fact, it was deep enough that it only takes 5 damage from it. But this is a sale right now. This is a ruse. Bomb setting up and already crossing the tunnels at B. And with 30 seconds left, they're going to go. Silent wins that frag as well. And now Peter, starting to rotate, sees a flash come through from the upper window, gets back in position, and he takes down Automatic. Sick can get all he wants on this lurk, but the CTs are aware of the fact that it is going to be inner. Sick gets a better one, though, taking down Justin. There's less for the retake. And Gobby, Sempus has the read, but the headshot comes through. He just has to hold true against the second shot at Vavanesse. He can go for the defuse immediately. Legia has Sick as well.
TSM coming in with a lot of these default slash fakes at the moment. Like, they're trying to see what kind of picks they can get towards Ivy. And if anyone does make anything happen, like Sick, this is then, they're fully executing towards the inside site. Getting the plant down once again, but Godby stepping up, finds those 2 kills. And just Sick left in, it was a 2 or 3 on 1. And he just didn't have a position to do anything with that. The full defuse is going to come in regardless. But he does drop in the end. And NRG closing the gap now. 6-5 against round number 12. AWP out on both teams. One of the few full gun rounds we've seen. Been lots of back and forth force buys here. Benji's still on the that single orb setup. Which is interesting. Remember at Counterpill, we actually saw Legia taking over the world as full time orb. Yeah, that's actually pretty decent.
That was, I mean, out of necessity. Obviously, of course, yeah. Turbulence and Peter don't get along. To be fair, that foot looked pretty messed up.
It did.
Speaking of, AWP towards the connector right now is going to have the rotation. 5 players set and ready to go in toward the inner bomb site right now from TSM. Split decision so far in the half, just 1 round dividing them after 11. Favor toward TSM, but that could change quickly if this rush gets shut down. They did have the Molotov drawn from Gobby's hands. And Peter is still here to cover the long angle, but right now, Peter, he's watching lower. Well, Gobby watches up. Excuse me, it leaves him in a more open angle, but FNS gets the trade. So the refrag onto Gobby. Bomb goes down, smoke on the first alleyway, flames on the second. Good quick scope in from Peter to take Twist.
Okay, then 4-3, the retake comes in. Legia goes in first, about his teammates caught behind the smoke as well. So Justin stepping up, taking on FNS, going to be a 3-on-2 now. They're going to be pushing through. Sempus of a very difficult angle here. He's out in the open with the AWP. He was almost dead to rights before that battle even began. Justin, been a player that's impressed me a lot recently. He gets 3 kills this round. And it was a decent approach from TSM, getting the bomb down once more. But Peter, as soon as he rotated in, he finds 2 frags. And he saw that positioning from Sempus is completely taken down. Had nothing really to work with there, just flashed out, stood in the open with the AWP. One of the most nightmare situations you can be in as an AWPer. But TSM do get the bomb down once again. The money's still pretty healthy here. Sempus back on towards the AWP. And NRG, now they do this, the double AWP setup. So interesting enough, it's going to be Silent joining him and not Legia, as we previously discussed. Round number 13. Nothing separating this team so far. We'll see what the next approach is from TSM. We haven't seen any full axe execution from them yet. Nothing like too crazy in terms of the walls of smoke and Molotovs coming out and working together to get a bomb down. It's kind of been working defaults, a couple of fakes chucked in, some inside takes, but nothing too locked down in terms of a set piece.
Justin's just going to wait on this angle to be favorable to play in his advantage. Peter covering it, both looking toward a main right now. It's all they need to do. No one really watching ladder, though. And as we can see it from the minimap's perspective, there is a couple players poised and ready to walk out. They make it to E-Box undetected. Peter spots it late. Now he has to hold one angle, not two. Molotov onto him, does hold true and hits the angle, but Sempus gets the shot instead. Good response from Justin, though. Because if they didn't hit that, if it had gone even 1-1 with that Molotov onto Z, it could have been a huge problem with TSM approaching, but now Silent on automatic. It's down to just two, and they're committed still. 47 seconds inside of the site. Bomb in the hands of Twist. Gets one shot onto Silent. It's going to encourage them to go forward still against three players that have rotated over. Good peek from Justin. Second shot as well.
Yeah, very nice spray control there from Justin. Once again, gets another three kills. And it's looking at NRG kind of warming up now. The players are starting to hit some key shots, and seems like the execution for TSM, they tried it that round. Didn't really work out too well for them. Going to round number 14, their money's not fantastic. Going to be going for the partial buy here. Some upgraded pistols, some armor, probably some grenades as well, I imagine, a few smokes. And this is where you're just trying to get the bomb done once again. Three smokes suggest they're probably going towards inside, but we'll see where they decide to go with this one. Did lose that double orb setup though for the CTs, NRG back just towards Peter. And yeah, this guy, so they're doing our set execution here. You can see them setting up on the mini-map right now. All around that dump set, that's where most of the smokes will be coming in, trying to just get the bomb down. And obviously with these like Tech-9s and PT-50s and CZs, you have a lot of run and gun potential. So we're trying to just push really smokes, catch some CTs by surprise. But as soon as the smokes go over, it's quite telegraphed. Peter, though, this is an audacious play from him. It does work out. Very nice stuff.
Now he's got the angle held as well, the confidence. Against pistols, it could have been a risk worth reward situation where if he'd gone down, the AWP was far enough forward. Legs the second player into Twist as well. You're talking about that telegraphing. Natsu was the one who spotted that Astralis liked to throw out decoys early on and try and sell those smokes. So as soon as you see them, you call the rotation and they hit inner as fast as possible. But right now it's 2v2. They've pulled this back. Automatic. He's going to do better. Still takes down Gobby. There's a chance. Justin behind the train. Has to hold true. Pistol does rain. And it is going to drop down. The bomb. Another re-peek. Another double for Justin late in the round. Three kills total this time. He was the guy at Counterpit that really stood out to me.
Yeah, absolutely. He was one of the players that I've never really been on my radar. And after watching him there, he's a really great talent. He's definitely up and coming in the NAC, and I'm sure we'll see a lot from him in 2016. He's actually coming on 15 frags. And TSM, although they had nothing really to work with there, that was a very tight round. He actually had the man advantage in that clutch situation. Peter opening things up. He got one kill, legged another, and the terrorists were forced to run through the Molotov then. And somehow they still brought it down to that sort of situation. But NRG, hold on. We're going to the last round of the half. They have got five AKs. Not the most utility in the world, but they have got smoke grenades and Molotovs. Looking like an inside play here. Four players committed so far. No fakes on the other side of the map, which we've seen a lot of. Silent has pushed towards the side of the area. Got beat. I think the spray on lower ramp gets two. Actually, with the round secured, the bomb is dropped as well. Legia coming in the back.
He's going to come in perfectly timed. They have no idea. Free kill automatic.
Hello.
Pull the trigger. Nearly gets divided between the two, but transfers it back over. And FNS might be inside of the site, but he's actually made this more interesting than I thought. Gobby should have relayed back onto him with the communication. Still a 1v3. Peter's there to hold it. 9-6. NRG actually pulled back. TSM were leading at one point in time, 6-5. So very well done from them to close out the half.
Yeah.
In fact, they were leading further than that, as you see it.
Pretty turbulent start there for NRG, but five clean rounds in the round in the end. I have to say, it wasn't like they were absolutely destroying them around. It's just Justin stepping up in loads of those key situations towards the end. Legia had some fantastic play towards inside as well. So overall, a decent half of NRG, I'd say. They did win the pistol and then get that hard reset from the pistols and AKs of TSM. But still anyone's game. We can't really separate these two right now. If TSM win the pistol, they're right back into it. On the CT side as well, it'll be 9-9. So still a lot to play for here.
Ely and Valens, the two coaches from either side. Both former players in the Pro Division within North America.
Valens, I haven't heard that name before. Should
you have not heard Valens?
No. Should I have
him? To be fair, I can't tell you the history off the top of my head. I've seen him lots. He's definitely been a prominent name in the
Ely, I remember we've casted him before.
Yes.
EGL.
Yeah, we
so
have.
That's the name I know, but Valens, I don't
know. He used to play with Ely Giggle. Just kidding, that's a lie.
Yeah.
No, Ely is, yeah, we've seen him before at PGL, but Valens actually is, of the two of them, the one that had a more successful stint as a player, in my opinion.
Fair enough.
So I think he was with Nihilum most recent. Yeah, it was Nihilum with Hiko is where he played.
Okay. Oh, that does make sense. That was at the weird stage of the NA scene.
Yeah, that was when Hiko kind of got messed around. Hiko was wrong, hashtag Hiko was right. He made a semifinal. Hiko was right.
I remember. Anyway. We go into round one of the second half here. NRG on the T side, four sets of armor. They've got one smoke with Molotov and four Glocks. So let's see what they decide to go with this one. Looking like a very simple inside play. Smoke down lower ramp. Molotov towards connector. Busting towards the inside site. You're almost guaranteed a plant regardless if you win the round.
That's a problem. Automatics caught in the open now. four players facing you. Yeah, it would have been must have gone down.
It would have been a blunder for NRG if they even got one kill there. So they did well finally to shut him down. You can see that this is what I'm talking about. Normally, got to be pushing down, finding those kills. But FNS, looks too easy for him. Somehow, he's given those two kills. Now, bomb will be planted. But still, huge advantage.
He's out of ammo. Gobby was out of ammo.
This is a mess. Absolute mess. They still have the Molotov for the...
He's got to do it right now. He's going to. Might be a little bit late. Has to peek it and do slight damage onto Sick. He has to get off of it. Oh my God, well done. It may just come to him in this situation. Do they have time? They've got no kit. Sick's on top of it. He's still taking damage, but there's... No, I think he's got it.
This is dead even. No, he's got it, I think. Yeah, he's got that.
Just barely. Actually, had about another half second to do so, but that could have been really close if that Molotov went out even a split second later. The thing is, he had to face Sick and get a little bit of damage into him because he was already on the defuse. What he didn't know is that it was 10 seconds.
That's a pretty clever approach for NRG. Obviously, most CTs, they might have one smoke on the pistol. That'd be about it, the hold off the initial choke point. But they're never going to save it for something like that. So it's quite a cool idea from NRG in the last remaining player. Had that Molotov, didn't really work out in the end with a 3-on-1. Did make it very exciting. Like you said, a couple more seconds could have done it. But it's TSM winning the pistol here. That gets them back into this one. Interesting enough, NRG not going for the AKs on the third. They want to answer back straight away here. And you can see, this is the buy I was talking about. This is what most teams will do when the bomb gets planted in the pistol. You get the famuses, you get the rifles, you can have one UMP. And it's not the worst buy. You still have head armor. They've got a lot to work with here.
But you're still prepped for the next round.
Yeah, exactly. So regardless of what happens here, you try and keep five players alive. And you know you're ready for those AKs should they come out. And still, they're ready for this right now. They've got pistols with head armor. So this one, especially on a map like Train, it's so long range. It means you're a lot more comfortable and holding back and more passive in the side, making the pistols less effective. Red RG now making their way towards inside. They have got the smokes and flashes. They'll be doing a set piece here, it looks like. Smoking off key areas on the map. Connector, lower ramp, maybe one on the train as well to defend them from someone like Automatic. And here comes the play now. Perfect reaction from him. It's going to slow them right down. They're going to have to run through, take a lot of damage. This round should be over from what I can see so far. It's a really nice play from TSM.
Oh, God, B. That's not how you use the CZ. Automatic with the kill. Into silent. Tempest follows up, and TSM in good position right now. They're only going to lose one. It is an SMG. It is the UMP at that, so there you go. They have the four rifles still in contention. They'll be able to buy up that fifth player, and they are poised and ready. Now, the question is, do they want to fully invest into that fifth player? Because, okay, that's actually smarter. Twist drops over. It actually leaves Automatic with 1,100 as he was at 39. It would have been limiting two people's economy.
So now NRG, they're pushing themselves a little bit, thinking, well, those AKs would have been very welcome right now. Could have done a partial by last round, get some kills, get the bomb down with a similar play, but they fully invested. Now they're going to be onto a full eco, pretty much. PT-50s and some Glocks, no nades. This is a throwaway round. They can somehow get a plan here. I'd be very impressed, but I don't see it happening. FNS going to be smoking out Pop Dog. He's just going to run through this. Hope for the best. Give him some kills. Let him farm. Come on. And the third. Lift it off. There it is. Nice shot from FNS. Almost too easy. As he gets three kills, Justin is the player. He has managed to get two kills there, so making it expensive for the CTs at least. Yeah, he'll be taking anyone by twist. 9-9. We said it could happen, and it has.
I've got a Steam notification. Everyone who's watching Twitch right now just alt-tabbed and went to their Steam.
Right.
And was like, oh, does someone want to play matchmaking? No. Oh, no one wants to play matchmaking with me. What was that?
Oh, you mean it was on our stream?
What a troll. Oh, yeah, sometimes in the case that they don't. Silent starts it off, though. Like, messaging Legia, smurfing. Just kidding, he would never do that. Don't ever take that serious. I'm completely joking. Before someone gets carried away with that idea, that wouldn't happen.
You and your big mouth.
I say jokes, which I think everyone would understand as a joke, but then I have to clarify sometimes in the case that they don't. Silent starts it off, though. The AK's with the early advantage. Massive damage on the twist, but it doesn't actually work out because he turns around and finds Silent, but Gobby and Legia, there's the answer. Down to 2v2.
Some of these fast outside executions, but so all of a sudden it's TSM binding two, and now we just got Peter in a 2v1. Should be able to get this kill. He was low HP as well. Doesn't pull the trigger. Should be taken down from connector now. That's where the other player is, but he's actually holding a very defensive angle. Peter gets the bomb, and now making his way towards the back tracks here. This actually could be a very good move from him as well. I'm not sure the CTs will have any read on this whatsoever, and he's going towards Ivy, so this kill is almost guaranteed on towards Automatic. If he checks it, that is. I think he will. There it is. Done. 1-on-1. Gives away his position, of course, but still lots of time to play with here. 50 seconds. And he's on the back tracks. He's going to be Sick trying to hunt him out. And this always comes down to the little timings and what we can do here. But Peter with a smoke towards connector, that's actually pretty smart. Now, Six of you trying to work out, what does that smoke mean? Does that mean he's trying to take away my vision? Is he a plant outside? Or is he trying to sell me a little fake here and trying to stop me from rotating?
Mm. This is interesting. He's taking his time, Peter. 24 seconds. He can afford to do so, but the more time taken...
Nice open plant.
This is actually quite good. Really open plant on the edge of the radius, and he can rotate back and try and get in a more favorable position to cut off Sick when he arrives. How does Peter play this? He can go in behind the tanker, but he's going to stay open. He is just barely going to get towards CT. Holds the shot, finds it through the edge of the wall. Headshot at that, and now NRG. They have the one round lead. It was 9-6, remember, so they win the first gun. That's pretty important.
I was kind of hoping he was going to get towards CT spawn. Now we can see the little mind games beginning, the fake defuses. That was such a nice play from Peter, but he goes for the straight up kill. Lands the shot through the corner of the wall. Headshot at that. And, oh, we've lost the game, Matt. It's happened.
That's all right. It's, again.
Back to us, I think.
Those Steam notifications that were open have
right,
ruined everything. I still actually see the game on our preview monitor, so that's interesting.
Yeah, because that's young.
Ah, okay. So don't worry about it. We can actually see. Everyone else is fine. It looks like at this point in time, the minimap is about 18 miles away from my vision, but they are setting up right now toward the outer bomb site. Good push up close behind the spools in B as well. Is going to get them lots of information. That's Finesse who's playing with just the CZ-75, so they need to make these rotations count with the fact that they only have three fully bought weapons, if you will, Henry.
I will.
You? Oh, he said he will. Now, if I could just get you to say I do.
No, not yet. I'm waiting until I'm 30. Which is very soon.
So we're not going to die. We're going to be dead before then.
TSM now, like you said, pretty weak by coming into this one. Both teams definitely struggling for the cash. Sick on the bomb site. It's going to be an Ivy play. Coming from NRG, looking at his first kill. It's going to be huge. Sick somehow finds it. But it's going to be responded straight away by God B. Bomb will be planted now. Nice open position. Only one kit on the CT here, so they need to act fast. Twist has been caught on the Molotov, but he's pushed past it. And he should find his kill on towards Justin. Gives his position away with that second grenade. Maybe hiding behind the server here, but not going to be enough. It's taken down. 3-on-3.
McGee.
Ooh.
I like it. Bye-bye, FNX. S. I saved it. Bomb planted, a man advantage in TSM. We saw without a roof last night, but this is without a chance in the round. Just so everyone knows, by the way, if we could switch to automatic really quickly. That thing that's beside automatic, we won't switch to him, but that little obstruction that he's sitting behind, that's actually the server.
Yes.
And that server is the server by which we are actually inside of playing the game. So it's a bit like Inception.
Yeah. So the server within the server.
If you walk over and shoot that server, what happens is we crash like we just did a minute ago.
So don't grenade it or anything. Make sure it's okay.
Don't Molotov it. Don't smoke it. Don't do it. And just leave Ivy open.
11-9, NRG with a big round there. That force weapon TSM didn't work out, but they do save an AK. It was a very fast, aggressive push from Ivy from NRG. Lost the first frag, but traded effectively. They got themselves into the bomb site, and once a bomb was planted, CTs didn't really have much of a chance. Lovely shot from the gear towards Pop Dog, but this should be an almost guaranteed round unless Twist can pull out some absolute magic here. Smoke's going down, pretty basic ones just to take away the visions of the CTs. They've stacked towards inside and Ivy here, so bomb should be planted pretty easily, and at that point, round should be over. Simon getting the first kill, that's towards Ivy, and FNS now. Trying to do what he can with that P250, actually works out pretty nicely. I'm not really sure why the CTs haven't got someone with him, but you know, why not give an AK away for free? For no real reason, but I'm fine with it. I've moved on that.
Well, moving on is the first part. This is an interesting setup in the fact that they know exactly where everyone is. Like, he is still facing this. He knows that they've only got the two AKs. But this is the more interesting one, is that FNS, excuse me.
Come on.
It's hard. He's actually starting to push onto Peter, and if he got there sooner, if he had been a little bit quicker about this, they had a chance for a flank to make this work. But like, he has shut down Tempest inside, and FNS has gone down to Peter.
Why do you call him Finesse, like you said again?
Finesse. I don't have any finesse.
Yeah, but he does, so call it out. 12-9. Money's starting to stabilize now. Twist does get the AWP, dropping it over to Semphis, of course. He's coming on 19 frags. But NRG looking very healthy indeed right now. They've got a nice full buy. All back on towards Peter. And we're going to round number 22. Let's turn around for NRG and see what they can do going forward.
Gobby's going to push the ladder. So they're just back to a position where they can rotate back around. Bomb intentionally dropped out toward T-spawn.
You can see exactly what he's trying to do here. All CTs will try and push through and gain some intel here by jumping on the dumpster.
Gobby's going to push the ladder. So they're just back to a position where they can rotate back around. Bomb intentionally dropped out toward T-spawn. Pop flash in, throws the... I don't understand that. Throws the pop flash so we can actually go down and then just tries to spray through instead.
I guess he's just trying to make CTs fall back at that point. Just like if you can hear footsteps, he doesn't want to commit and potentially throw his kill away.
You could be right, because now they're looking toward inner, so they just didn't want to go give away a flank.
Yeah, but it forces CTs back. And like they'll hear footsteps, it gets a little bit of intel regardless. But now he's doing the same thing again, so he will be coming in this point. Flashes down the gear is the first one to drop. And now they've got control of the Pop Dog Room. Still plenty of time to work with as well. It's just dissecting the map right now. You can see Justin and two other players with the bomb as well will be towards the end of Ivy. They've smoked off the right-hand side and can actually maybe go towards backtracks here. This could be interesting, considering you can see two players towards inside. They can do the inside split, which we normally talk about, Matt. I know you're a fan of this strategy.
I am, actually. This is pretty clever, but FNS is here. Uh-oh. Oh, they make it too easy. The lineup, but Justin's there. Meat Shields, for one, gets the kill. Immediately turned back. And Peter's going to push through. Smoke finds Twist. It looked like he would be all over the place as he caught himself on the edge of the wall trying to bunny hop. Gobby misses the jump toward Ticket Boot, but still in a good position to cut off Semphis as the bomb goes down. He's going to take further than that. It's Molotov'd off from his own team, but he makes it back through just barely alive on 40. And it's going to be all onto automatic AWP to try and make this work, and I highly doubt he's going to fully commit to this.
Just holding the CT step right now. Ooh, should have been hitting that shot, I would say, but not going to happen for him now. They know exactly where he is. You would assume this pincer from the inside sight will be working out for the terrorists. It's going to be the gear. And will be finding first contact and automatically falling back the wrong way as well. He'll be dying almost certainly here. It'll take some miracle shots to keep him alive. Slowly but surely, it comes in. Justin baiting it in with some sound there, but it's going to be the gear to hit that final kill. Lovely stuff from NRG. Get their 13th round on the board. And it's starting to fall apart now for TSM. It was a very close game in the first half, but now they are on an eco once more, so it will be 14-9. Unless he's CZ, can pull out some very impressive shots. Four of them, in fact, and a 5-7 on sick. Round number 23.
And it plays at 13-9. Yes, yeah, slows it again. A little bit more aggression out toward Ivy. This time they've got the first player automatic around the corner already. Silent was watching it, but he's elected to fall away from this. And the pistol can't afford to commit to it either, because it's a very narrow corridor to try and hold with just a CZ-75. So he sits inside Ivy instead. Good shot from Peter, take down Semphis.
Yeah.
And now they start to move forward inside of the bomb site, clearing out quad, clearing out the angle. Sick manages one more with the pistol. They've actually taken two guns down already. Bomb was dropped in the process, but it's still looking all right. Justin nearly gets TK'd there.
Automatic is actually in a decent position here. Undetected. The bomb will be planted. That hill went around, but potentially could get a couple of kills. You can see Peter and Justin, no HP. Spots one, doesn't pull the trigger. Perfect. There it is. This could actually get interesting now, but there it is. Like I said, wasn't ever going to win the round, but definitely had the opportunity to do a lot of damage there. Gets one, but NRG, the headliners, they get their round number 14. TSM with the eco on the last. Do have a triple sniper setup here, Matt. We saw a penta sniper setup yesterday, but it's just going to be three today.
Yeah, that was pretty nuts. And they won the round on it.
That was the first. They were 9-0 down. I think not Stevie missed the game. They actually got four orcs and an auto sniper. Never seen that before in my professional casting career, I have to say. But it worked. So.
Yeah, auto sniper right now for FNS. Ooh. Semphis did spot the elbow. Gets it on the second shot because he's distracted from the corner where automatic has fallen. So it's one for one, still favors energy in this sense. Nobby's gonna go down, flash in, takes the peek. Can't get the shot on the Semphis yet, but does, and the second flash comes in. It doesn't matter, he's already dead. He's already gone. All it serves to do is push back FNS inside the Z connector. And he looked like he was bailing out and going home, but they say, nope, let's go. We got an auto sniper, why not? Twist gets the shot onto Peter, and they do push forward. Justin has to hold it, Sick goes down. Auto sniper's still in play right now from FNS, but look at this flank, Silent. He's gonna catch them before they can even go for the save. Auto sniper taps once. It's dead, but Silent. That's a nifty little shot back toward the Z connector. Gobby always there. Map point now for NRG. Map one of our best of three.
As soon as NRG got the read where Semphis was there, they completely exploited his position. It was automatic facing from up, and that's what allowed them to get that first pick, TSM. But as soon as they took him down, they went towards the lower ramp, flashed him out, Semphis. And then Gobby hit a lovely shot to get in towards the bomb site, and that retake with an order sign for Ananorp as well. Once they've been smoked out, Twist did what he could, but it just wasn't enough, map. It's going to be 15-9 now, of course, force buying into this. Max Evans, a famous buy, make it three of them. No kits. Little amount of utility, you need to push here. It's going to be automatic. Game towards inside, lands the headshot with the Max 7, gets the kill as well. The gear once again, a lot of weird positions they're caught. I'm not getting the refrags here, but it's not going to matter. Justin and Peter stepping up, and automatic has been taken down low as well. So this should be over at this point. The Twist, still believing, going to be pushing towards Ivy. If he gets the timing right, which he does, he takes down Asylum.
Gob's not going to face that either. He walks back in toward A main. They have got Justin up toward health, so we could try and catch them back in return from Ivy. But Sempfis pushing through B has made it to ladder. He's going to try and pincer this. Gobby getting him, though. That opens up A entirely, and they know now that they have to make a move out from this Ivy position. They're outside of their own grounds. Twist will be the first one in again. Look at the angle held right now from Hell. Justin just sitting in that corner waiting for him to push through smartly. Twist is going to wait and try and allow them to get toward the bomb first. And now he's making an awful lot of noise. Justin has the rotation. He's figured it out. He's going to play toward Hitch. He's going to just simply try and make this his obligation. Smoke out towards Z-Connector. Flashes as well. Twist might actually read this to say, they think I'm coming from the wrong direction. And Justin tries to fool him with it. Automatic takes down Peter. It's now down to just Gobby and no bomb planted. 26 seconds. But low HP on Automatic, who now has an AWP.
Gobby now has got the bomb. And a couple of options here. We'll be just pushing through the smoke, and he gets his down. I've already said this train is one of the most difficult maps to retake, especially when you have no kits as well. Very open plant coming in. They have upgraded to Famuses and AKs here. Could be automatic this low, but Gobby, if that plant can decide to...
Both going ladder.
Yeah, so this, if he gets that first kill, comes out to a one-on-one, so TD's going to be very careful how they approach the situation. It could be automatic going down first. You'd assume he's automatically dead. He is.
But this is the thing. He's not going to expect both. He's on the ladder. He's given away. That was actually quite smart from TSM. There's a not a likely situation. They would both be coming from the same angle. So Twist gets three kills in the round. They stay alive.
Just about.
To make it into double digits.
It comes down to another one versus one. And he does say an AK and a little bit of utility there, but still, they're going to struggle to rebuy for this one. Looking for an AWP here. Not going to find it. So money's okay. Automatic has 5,400, so it's not awful. But still tons of cash here for the terrorists. You've got B. Could have got the AWP, but they haven't gone for it. So this would... This would suggest to me, Matt, that we're going for the final set piece here. They know the money to be low for the CTs. Do the wall of smokes outside, try and get the bomb down. They probably won't have much to answer back in terms of incendiary or an AWP. So this would probably be the perfect time to drop one of those in. We'll see what their approach is by now. It's actually six rounds in a row unanswered for NRG before TSM actually got on board. And that was a very weak fight. Here's a set execution. And this is a perfect call, I would say.
Sick gets a little apprehensive. Twist gets silent, though, starting it off well for TSM. In fact, a two-man advantage brought back, though, as Gobby gets one, but he's now the last alive. On the bomb train, one versus four, finds the first kill. He's trying to get away, but too quickly they will approach an FNS. Finesse.
Finesse, yeah. You're getting that. Well, then, that makes things interesting, at least. NRG now do have to go to an eco. Please don't force this, chaps, because it's not worth it at this point. Just win the round, win the game. And we'll see what you can do after that. But TSM has brought this off, potentially a couple here. We'll see how this one goes down. Gobby, the only player to really invest with some body armor and a CZ. Desert Eagles, PT-50s from the rest of the guys. And we'll see if they can do anything with this. No grenade purchase. This should be almost guaranteed round for TSM. Need to make sure they keep everyone alive. Make sure they can potentially get an AWP next round. Still, now you just need one round here. Getting to the closing sectors of the first map of this best of three. But it's nice, man. We don't normally get to cast much NACS. We've got lots to do this week.
We have lots. Sick has Justin. Justin 9. Because he didn't quite make the 10. But Sick and FNS set up a crossfire. Pretty straightforward. They're actually making a game out of this now. Avoiding that reset. Managing to string rounds together in succession. Money's still not perfect on the energy side, but likely I'd expect a buy because they've got three rounds already accumulated. No AWP, though. That's the crucial aspect out of all of this.
They've got five smokes, one Molotov, but as I said, Semper's now back on the AWP. They're looking to get this three rounds in a row. Definitely not impossible. We'll see what they can do with this one. Some early smokes coming over for the terrorist hit. That fast rush is like a pro-esque. Going to be going straight out there, flashing through as well. Sick has got his work out and gets one player running in front of him. He pulls out the Glock. And he's going to be taking down the end, but Twisted there to back him up. Silence, just a back and forth exchange here, but some lovely shots there from Senfis. He's going to secure the round 3-1 now. Just going to be looking at remaining. And they're pretty much, I would say, impossible situation, but you never know. They're not looking towards his direction right now. There's one kill, looking for the second though. Not going to be pulling the trigger just yet. This is actually kind of exciting. But the fact he didn't take that kill is now looking like he may have missed an opportunity.
Yeah, negligible given the fact of his positioning.
Maybe he's taking that kill with a force to face on the other one, but
okay, that works.
All right, here we go, Matt.
I must be where are we quiet. We're hunting wabbits.
I'm scared. I'm scared.
It's two. Just tap. The scope. He unscoped. But Legia's there. He does get both. That's a scary moment. That is a scary thought. And Automatic now faces a one-on-one against Legia with 43 seconds to play. The bomb was not retrieved in all of that. An Automatic shuffled across. Yeah, it's up above. This is the big problem out of this. And Automatic does spot him just barely. And he's going to try and slow peek it. Legia gets back behind the train. But Automatic takes this yet another round. Round 28. Done and dusted. We will hit 29 at 15-13.
Overtime looking very probable here. As now NRG down to a pretty much full eco, but man, Legia did make that exciting, right? That was like, as I was saying, it seemed like after he didn't take that initial kill, I'm not sure what's going to come of it, but somehow gets away with those two frags, comes down to the one-on-one, unable to find that final kill. Would have been an absolutely epic round. How do you pull that off? It wasn't meant to be. Round number 29. I've got some body armor, a few flashbangs, and some upgraded pistols. That's about it for the T's. There's going to be Senfis opening things up. He pushed towards that upper ramp. Takes down Peter. And now the outside play coming in. Trying to get a bomb down here. Boost there. Economy for the final round of regulation time, but it's not going to happen. Getting absolutely wrecked here. But you find one kill on automatic. That's about it.
This is impressive. Another back and forth style half where it's a late CT charge, similar to how NRG took a 9-6 halftime lead. Senfis onto the AWP. Peter will do the same this time.
Indeed, he had $5,800, so he doesn't really get much to play with. He gets the orb and some armor. And we'll be seeing whether he can actually find something happen here. Interesting enough, Peter's got a pretty high ping. I guess he's not at the house right now. He had like an 85 ping.
He probably didn't want to fly there. He has a fear of flying now.
True. He would though, wouldn't he?
Not really. That's a freak accident. You don't take that one too serious. Silent. You might not go to the bathroom on the plane. Silent. Gonna stay toward the off angle right now, peek out toward Ivy. That shot serves to give his position away to Twist, though. Don't shoot the server, we'll crash. I don't like crashing. Another smoke out. That's got a massive gap. Silent's not gonna try and take advantage of it. He could have. But they've got other plans, because right now, as we can see it, bottom left of the minimap, three players set to go in toward the inner bomb site. And it is just Automatic that's inside of the site to hold it by himself. They have brought a second player with an M4 back over toward the Z connector. It's FNS that's going to be playing far from behind, but Senfis already rotating. They've slowed this right down, NRG. Trying to bleed out TSM, and they've got one smoke left, but they've also got two Molotovs still to play with on the CT side.
Number 30, and we hit the 30-second mark as well. Twist will be pushing towards Ivy, and this is where the T's are executing as well. He could probably find a couple of kills here. He's making some noise. I did not hear him, but this is going to be very influential. Twist is going to be in the perfect position. As soon as his teammates get some distraction here, he'll come in and clean things up. Let's go, Twist.
And Sick doesn't need to do much other than slow them down in this situation, because as soon as Twist shows up, but he goes down a little bit early. I was going to say, as soon as Twist shows up, it's all too easy. He does find the first kill, though. Automatic taking down Peter. This is going to be an overtime game for TSM as they take down Justin. So from 15-9, we hit 15-15, Henry.
Yep, the overtime bell rings.
Is that what that bell means?
I think so. I think I worked it out. It's the overtime bell. So, what looked like a very convincing case. I think NRG got six rounds in a row there towards closing stages in the second half. Somehow TSM come back with a force buy and actually make things happen for themselves and actually take down control of those clutches. Some very exciting moments, you have to say, in terms of like that Legia round, but it wasn't meant to be, apparently. And we see him actually coming out on top. It's going to be overtime. How do you feel like it's going to go down? Oh, it's his camera, isn't it? Fine.
I don't know, Henry, if I had to ask. I mean, both teams, it was one of those games where obviously it's a close scoreline, but it was streaks. Mm-hmm. It's not like it was knotted back and forth action. It was literally momentum shifting.
Well, the first
and you could argue that both teams adapted, but both teams also fell short.
The first half is all about the money. It seems like both
teams. Yes, that's true.
Back and forth, literally. Someone would be forced by it, then someone else would. Then they went around, and then they get forced by themselves. And it was like that was for the first six or seven rounds that was going on. It wasn't until the second half that someone got a clear victory in terms of multiple rounds, consecutive build-ups. That was NRG. They got six in a row. And we thought that was over at that point. So they hit, like, what was it, 15-11, I think it was, or maybe 15-10 at one point. And they somehow couldn't close out. And it's going to be getting straight back into this one, ladies and gents. So this is it. We're in overtime with the first map of this best of three. There it is. The bell has been rung. You heard it here first. And now it's a full reset. So I'm not sure we've rules play. MR3, 10K, it looks like.
To be fair, probably not the first place they've heard a bell, Henry.
What are you referring to?
Nothing. I'm just saying.
Oh, it's not even a joke.
It's a fact.
Right.
Behind the server, Twist shall play. But Silent and Peter to face away. It's two. With the same angle to try and get at least the trade. You've mentioned how they play this to try and make sure, even if they lose one, the second can get a refrag immediately, but Twist inside this smoke. This could be clever. They might check it. Are they going to wait? This actually works for Silent because he gets inside of the smoke and gets in behind the server. They try and chase him down. Peter's there. A big lead finally for Energy, something they couldn't find in regulation. The shot onto Semphis. And now the site surely given up. It's late smoke. And even better still, as Justin re-peeks out, takes automatic. It's down to FNS.
Justin finishes things off. Peter, though, he's the MVP of this round. Lovely, close range. Shotgun start orbits from him. And now it's going to be finesse towards that IV area. And with MR3, 10K, every weapon's valuable. He needs to be saving this weapon. We've seen it time and time again. If you do two in a row, we've invested in orbs as well. You're going to struggle going to the third. So I'd say trying to stay alive at this point, it's not even worth him trying to get kills there. Terror is negligible. If you do get kills or not, he'll be taken down in the end. Every buck counts in this one. There it is, Matt's got a message.
I don't even understand how this phone does this. Everything is literally turned on silent and it will find a way to send me a message every single night. I don't understand you. Buy HTC, not this hunk of junk that I've had to buy because I lost my HTC. And if you want an
PS,
M10,
I'll... Send Max, send
if
send
you want an M10, I'll give you a promo code that'll get you $100 off.
Okay, there we go. 16:15 now, and we go into round number two of this MR3 overtime. Back in the WP, we'll see what the players from NRG. Three players towards inside right now, and there's only one for the CT. You can see that's automatic. And that shot from Semphis, it does hit, but he does not find the frag. Peter now with the advantage. So he's going to be waiting for the refrag from, or the refit to take from Semphis, but he gets the better of him through the wall this time. And it's enough damage to take him down here, 15 HP. So now the rest of his teammates are towards inside, but the bomb is down towards T-spawn. What's the next play here, Matt? What's going on?
Get kills.
Ah, yes. That works.
I mean, the play right now, the interesting thing is the bomb is so far away from the other three, but if they can try and open up this B site, the very long rotation position right now from the three players that are inside of the A site from the CTs, because they're all playing out toward hell, two at quad, in fact. But now the attack will go onto the B site. Automatic finds one. Good positioning. He's going to go up top of the ladder on the train. They'll have heard that climbing up, and he drops silent. That's the bomb carrier. He's done more than that. Automatic's doing it alone. As he's gotten three kills, and he closes it. I take that back. He gets the assist. Twist steals it. How crude. Nonetheless, 16-16, a good response from TSM.
16-16, you're right. And a pause coming in. So we have to come to words, don't we?
They don't have to. I think
we should come to words before the bye comes in, please.
Someone tweeted me saying that I was actually... Nice. It's apparently a TeamSpeak issue. I was actually...
Yes, but still...
trying out for Mumford & Sons the way I'm dressed. But Henry, what really happened is I packed to come to Europe for 2 months and 20 minutes and brought too much clothing, and I thought, if they're here, I'm going to wear them.
Yeah, I like them. They're good. Shirt's nice and snug as well.
Really does accentuate my lovely belly. It's our kid, okay? Do you want to feel it kicking?
Oh, it's a strong one. It's a big boy.
At least he's got that going for him.
Not like his dad.
I'm the mum, so this is fine. I'm the one that's pregnant.
Anyway, so we go into ours just because online CS with the boards and stuff, especially
with coaches.
The third round and stuff like that, we don't want to see teams like some getting some intel from the stream or anything like that. So you come to ours and we'll fill the time until the pause is over. I think this is a TeamSpeak thing, so
yes,
surely it's quite easy to fix.
How did you know that?
What?
There's a TeamSpeak
You
thing.
Said it.
Oh, did I say it? I didn't think I did. I have a good phone and you don't.
This is the whole thing with Matt. Like he said, the inappropriate jokes earlier, his brain works a bit fast. No, his mouth works a bit faster than his brain does. So sometimes he forgets the things he says.
My brain works too fast for my mouth, is how I like to put it, Henry.
Okay.
A little bit different semantics. The good news is for TSM, as you kind of mentioned, that in the MR3 10K overtime, if you lose two in a row, you're in a position where you have to save. And they did manage to win the second round. So they're actually in a really good position. Not only that, they've picked up, I won't say what, but they picked up a few weapons to make it a little bit more interesting for their buy-in.
We're going to pause now, so feel free to go crazy.
It's double op setup that they're going to be running on the CT side, one of which was a donation, if you will. So this is actually all right. Peter's gone to buy his own. They can buy out. It doesn't matter. They're going to swap it over next time. But this round is very important because, as we know, this game has been back and forth in terms of where the rounds have been achieved.
Indeed. Well, it's the final round of the first half of overtime here. Silent going towards Sadali with that smoke as well. So I'm going to see if there's any CT aggression coming in with the bomb. Very similar setup to what we saw last round, but the bomb is inside this time. Swiss, Twist, as you said, the secondary AWP now joining up with Semphis. I think this is the first time we've seen the double AWP setup for the CT actually. And TSM.
No, because we saw the double AWP auto sniper.
True.
Justin going to spray down. One, it's sick to drop. Finesse to follow. Gobby now has the lead for his team to work with. It's only 13 HP as well for Semphis. A Molotov will distill him. In fact, it's doubly thrown. It spreads further than he realizes, and it will be the end of him. Down to just two, automatic and Twist. Such stark contrasting rounds in the fact that they're so convincing one way and then immediately canceled out the other. Energy have the 17th round. And a very fast halftime. We'll swap it back over and see if they can close this out. 19, the magic number.
2-1 on the terrorist side for NRG. They didn't have a great terrorist half, but it was the closing sectors, the money was a problem for them, that they actually had a problem there. So 2-1, TSM now swapping over. As you said, 19 is the magic number here, so NRG just need two. TSM need two just to take us to the next regulation, well, the next set of overtime, I should say. But I'm sure they'll take all the time they want here to kind of discuss their options. This is when I want to see some crazy plays, man. I want to see some aggressive CD pushes. We haven't seen any like two-man pushes towards Ivy at the beginning of the round. We haven't seen any like pushes inside or anything like that. I want to see a little bit more crazy ideas and some big plays coming in. What would you like to see? Second half begins, ladies and gentlemen.
I was listening to Reese. Apparently, by putting this, these mics have crazy pickup because this little tiny headset, which I can't hear unless it's slammed in my ear, was being picked up by the microphone. No, so Reese was on stream.
Was he?
Yeah.
He's made it. Welcome to the big leagues.
He was. The interesting thing is some of the information is private. So all you people that heard it, you're going to die after this. I have to kill you. I'm sorry. Double up out of the gate means that this is even more fragile now for energy. Silent and Peter are going to be running it. As you mentioned, Silent at counter pit did elect to run the AWP out of necessity.
That was the gear.
It was the gear. You're right, actually. No. That is a good point. Silent, I think, was the double up even in that situation. There you go. Do you remember when the train was first released, this remake of train and those doves, you could actually get on top of them?
Yeah, you could fly out the map.
Out of the map. Yeah, that was outrageous.
That was pretty funny. Anyway, first half here, Silent does spot a player jumping above the server. They must be clearing it out now. Any close range CTs that may be waiting behind it. Smoking off the vision as well so they can push up before they make the next move. But Silent with a decent Molotov as well. Will just be delaying them in the same fashion. Does he decide to push through this though? That's a pretty nutty call, but I like it. I said I want to see some big balls plays, and he's going to be providing the next one. Looking for that kill on towards Twist. It's Peter going aggressive towards main as well. This is going to be his first pick before falling back into more classic hold.
Silent to watch every move from Twist. Gets a little bit bored of it, though, and decides, I want to look elsewhere.
Inside play now.
It is going to be the inside play, but it's all for a fake right now. Back toward ladder. Peter with this double up set up with Silent together inside of this site. Have a lot of work up close to do. Peter's got the first shot. And as they try and hunt him down, he baits them into a position where Justin and Silent are perfectly set up to take them. But it is Twist late from Ivy that's now pulled it back. Two kills for him. Peter's got to do it all. And FNS is left in the open. Good flank, good timing. Leahy has got the kill, and now it's going to be one round to go for energy.
Absolutely right. Nice work there. An aggressive AWP style from Peter. Just negating both of his positions between what Pop Dog and main entrance, and found the first kill. The timing working in his favor, took down one, caused enough distraction as well from his teammate from the bomb side to get some M4 spray down, and then Silent does get that kill towards Silent as well. But here we go then, round number five. As you said, one more required for NRG. No AWP for TSM here. This suggests normally this is going to be more of a set piece. And they're making their way towards Pop Dog and inside. It's going to be sick towards the Pop Dog area. But Legia looking to challenge here. This kill could be big. I think this should get up. There it is.
Why not? TSM actually getting two opening kills as Semphis is going to take down Justin as well. Makes it now a decent advantage to work with, but Peter pulls that back as he finds the shot out toward Quad. Six going to get up the ladder late, silently in his process, but with two players out toward Ivy, so this should go back toward A because there's already two rotated. The other option is if they can find the kill at the outback, they can rotate through CT spawn. That should give it up. That should bring the bomb back to A.
Yes, you're absolutely right. Now it will be a Pop Dog Ivy split. It's going to be sick with the bomb. He does go down. That's a massive problem here, so he needs to be very careful. Gets himself a more defensive position, but it's Silent taking him down. That's the bomb dropped as well. The game is up. It's up to them now to just force forward. Okay. Interesting move from Silent. I thought he just wanted to stay alive at that point, but besides the challenge, now it's a 2-on-2.
But he does get the information. They're both there, and Peter can firmly fix his sights upon the gateway, which they will enter. Takes down FNS bomb, still on the ground, then he's got the other shot as well. Solid game from Peter, I have to say.
Yeah, I would say so, absolutely.
27 kills, very good frag distribution for everyone on the side from Silent. There's usually quite consistent, both teams as well. TSM all within the 20 ranges, but it is NRG that end up winning it 19-16. It was 15-9 at a point, a little bit closer than I would have thought. Yanko, you were observing, and that means you probably saw more than I did.
No, it means exactly the opposite, Matt. I had to focus to bring you guys all the action so you can do your job well. Couldn't focus that much on the game.
It's a wasted effort to make me do my job well, though.
Yeah, that's true, but Henry's here, so, you know, someone, we have a true professional here, and he's doing his job really well. Yeah, but watching the game,
be nice to me.
On the T side, most of the time, it seemed that both teams were just, there were a lot of rounds where for even a minute, 50 seconds, 45 seconds, nothing is happening. It basically came down to the T's waiting for the CTs to spend their smokes, grenades, and then going for a for some sort of a split or maybe a B take. And at times it did look pretty sloppy and uncoordinated. Some overextensions as well by players individually. I know Henry gets particularly triggered by those moves because simply just unnecessary. I mean, the perfect, the great opposite example of it is NIP, right? It's a team that one of the main reasons why they're to keep on buying.
You can see it unfolding there. That's why I get so annoyed by it. It's before they even do, I say, all you need to do is stay alive in this scenario and they've won the round. But all of a sudden, you can see like he's getting tempted. He thinks, oh, if I get one more kill here, that would look really cool and I'll secure the round.
What is this thing is like dead to me.
I mean, Matt, we still
I'm just going to turn it off. This is outrageous.
We still have at least 3 hours. You're going to have a good bank, a good economy to keep on buying.
You can see it unfolding there. That's why I get so annoyed by it. It's before they even do, I say, all you need to do is stay alive in this scenario and they've won the round. But all of a sudden, you can see like he's getting tempted. He thought, oh, if I get one more kill here, that would look really cool and I'll secure the round.
What is this thing is like dead to me.
I mean, Matt, we still
I'm just going to turn it off. This is outrageous.
We still have at least 3 hours. You cannot go
on
Tinder now. There's no time for a Tinder date.
First off, I don't get that many matches. I got two pings tonight. There's no way I got two matches. It's me we're talking about. And second off, it is literally on silent, not even vibrate.
Anyway, talking about silence.
Point was I making? Yeah, let's just go with him. Anyway, yeah, so it went to overtime, of course. NRG had a massive advantage. They should have been winning that one after, what, they had like 15-11 at one point?
59.
Was it 59? Was it that close? Yeah. Good Lord. Yes, the money situation was pretty poor for both teams, actually. Like, we saw them struggling. A lot of very strange force buys, especially NRG in the first half. Like, what was that about? I was going to ask you. Yeah. Like, they did a force buy with, like, I think it was, like, three deagles and, like, one rifle, and then they went
followed
the next round.
And did another one.
Full 5.7s with armor and stuff. Like, that didn't make any sense. If you're going to do one or the other, you either take a full eco, or you do a partial buy, and then you take a eco after that. But they just went for force buy, no money. So literally the worst of both worlds in that scenario. But still, they won, so, you know.
They did win. We go to Mirage next. We will take a short break, but thoughts on Mirage in the fact that it's a little more open in its play style than the cluttered quadrants of Train?
Well, it would definitely suit TSM more in a sense that, as you mentioned, their screamy play style, puggy play style, it's much easier to pull it off on Mirage than it is on Train. But then again, on the other side, you have Gobi and Legia, who were playing for Mouse Sports and really played that map a lot when they were in the team. So they have a pretty good idea of how to play it. I was going to say I'm going to expect a closer map, but you can't get any closer than overtime, although I felt that it was NRG letting that game go to overtime. In the end, we're going to have to wait and see. As I said, you can never really predict these online games. But yeah, on paper, should be a better chance for TSM to win this one.
Yeah, I agree. I can't say I've watched them tons on Mirage, if anything. But so, but like you said, it seems like they're fragging well. Semper seems to be coming to life with the AWP. I'd say it's going to be an interesting battle between him and Peter going into this one. Peter seemed to be very hot towards the end there. You kind of pointed out,
haven't you? Yeah, he was excellent at the end.
In the overtime, especially.
He had a bunch of entry kills as well on the CT side.
We'll see what that pans out to be. But I'm still going to stick with my prediction. I still think 2-0 at NRG. I think like it'll be another close game. It's difficult to say which path will go down, but I still think 2-0 is
And it was a little bit closer than I did expect. I mean, when it was 15-9, I thought that's surely it. So credit where credit is due to TSM on train. We will take a short break. When we come back, we'll have all 10 on the server be ready to go on Mirage, and we'll find out if TSM can keep it close and potentially push this to 3 maps, or if we get ready for Cloud9 and Luminosity now. We'll find out. We'll see in a minute.